guys, Michael Hunter here, and welcome to Super News! Gaming! So it looks like there are a few more details that I'd like to point out about Sonic Mania Plus that I missed on the previous video. First off, I need to correct a mistake that I made on that video. I originally said that it was coming out in June. I don't know where exactly I got that date from, but that's not when it's coming out. It, in fact, is coming out July 17th. So, you can look forward to it then. Now, a lot of the additional details that I'll be talking about mostly comes from Famitsu, which has a lot of details about Sonic Mania Plus. But it's all in Japanese. So, with a combination of help from Black Kite from Twitter, TSSZ News, and PlayStation Lifestyle, I've been able to look up some English translations for everything. And as a result, we got some pretty cool details. So, first off, if you already have Sonic Mania already downloaded, and you just want to upgrade without the whole physical copy thing, it's only going to cost you $4.99. But that's in the US market. In pounds, it'll cost you $3.99. We also have new details on exactly how Mighty and Ray will play. When Famitsu was interviewing Sonic Mania's producer, Takashi Iizuka, they asked him about the gameplay styles of the two new characters. He responded with this. Mighty the Armadillo has a setting of being a strong guy, and he has a hard shell on his back. By making use of that, we made it into a technique to drop vertically to the ground and make it shake. Also, he can repel enemy bullets with the shell. And when he's curled up, he can prevent damage once. Doing a sudden drop to the ground is a rare action in the classic series indeed. So based off of that, it looks like we do get more than just a simple ground pound. And knowing that the ground shakes when he lands probably indicates that enemies will either get stunned or get destroyed when they're nearby. And then later on, he elaborates on just how useful Mighty's hammer drop can be by talking about Encore mode. He says the stages themselves are the same as Mania, but by rearranging the objects and gimmicks, you can enjoy them with a different sensation. Besides, it also makes Mighty able to make use of his actions more. For example, we're adding the ability to open holes in the ground with Mighty's hammer drop. And when he goes on to talk about Ray the Flying Squirrel, he says, since he's a flying squirrel, we instantly decided on a gliding action. Although it may be similar to Knuckles gliding, Ray can raise up with effort. Depending on the player's technique, he can fly for very long. So like I said in the previous video, this still reminds me of Cape Mario from Super Mario World, which was basically the same way. As long as you have the right technique, you can fly for a very long time. Even pretty much infinitely, so I'd assume it probably functions the same way. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Either way, it's definitely an action that we've never seen in a Sonic game before, and I'm really looking forward to seeing how this will feel in actual gameplay. Based off of what was said so far though, it looks like we don't get any new abilities outside of his gliding. We know that Mighty Shell can deflect bullets, along with being able to do his hammer drop, but so far it looks like Ray can only glide. In that case, it would make him very similar to Tails. And for him, it's not really an issue, so it's probably not an issue here as well, if this is really his only ability. And another detail about Encore mode that I find really interesting, which is definitely a game changer. In Encore mode, the stages will have different gimmicks and color palettes, which, of course, we already knew that a long time ago. But it then states that you can switch between 5 characters when the button prompt shows up. So, are we getting some kind of Sonic Heroes throwback here? Wait a minute. This is set in the past though, so wouldn't that make it a Sonic Heroes throw forward? Anyway, perhaps it'll play similarly to Sonic 2 Heroes, the ROM hack. So, those were the main details I wanted to touch on. The game is looking great so far, and I, for one, can't wait to get my hands on it, as I loved the original Sonic Mania. And this one looks even better, which is mind-blowing to me. So, what do you guys think of these new features? Are you looking forward to it? I definitely am. So, those are all the details I can find for now. This is Michael Hunter, and I will see you guys next time. Later!
Thanks for watching. Subscribe.